It's Fox's breakout hit of the season, but what does it take to build an empire?
We flew to Chicago to take you behind the scenes, and if you think the show is already filled with twists and turns, the actors tell us, just wait. Welcome to Chicago. While the show is actually based in New York City, it's filmed here in Chicago, and this entire city block makes up the sound stages. We're going inside to show you behind the scenes and talk to some of the cast that you love and love to hate. Come on.
Empire State of Mind. Let's go.
These 17 hard years for that money.
It was your sacrifice that made a lot of this possible.
I feel good. I would watch the show even if I wasn't in it. I'm just
so glad that I am.
You got all of it. Now we just gotta show the world. The best time for it, we can do it. Like, if we get all the pieces of the puzzle together, this can be amazing.
The whole thing just felt like I was the luckiest girl in the world.
Fans are latching onto the show that's got soap opera drama mixed with an R&B beat.
I need you to sing like you are going to die tomorrow.
It centers around music company Empire Enterprises and the members of the Lion family as they fight for control of it.
Now, it won't happen today, nor tomorrow, but I will start grooming someone soon.
There's Lucius, Cookie, Andre, Jamal, and Hakeem, surrounded by a memorable cast of supporting characters.
What are they doing to me?
Looks like they're having a meeting to me.
While the likes of Taraji Henson and Terrence Howard are already Hollywood A-listers.
Oh my God, Lucius, you gotta go.
The show introduces us to new talent, including Jussie Smollett.
What's your first love? Is it the acting or the music? Because this shows off your talent, this show.
Being an empire is my first love because I get to do it all. What do I gotta do? I guess I'd say like entertaining is my first love. My mama is from like old school, you know, like Judy Garland, Joan Crawford, Lena Horne type of situation where you're just supposed to know how to do everything. See that I can
be. Jamal gets into some heavy stuff with his dad on the show. What kind of feedback have you been getting from fans?
I'm getting a lot of love. You know, I get letters on the regular about people that are inspired by Jamal. I get that from gay, lesbian, bi, transgender. Heterosexual kids. It seems like it's finding, Jamal is somehow finding his way into the hearts of everybody because I feel there's that universal story of not being accepted.
Who's that?
Portia, my new assistant, probationary.
You want to call her? She said it's urgent.
I said get out of here.
So you got this dream job, and not only that, this show's a huge success. What does that feel like, and did you ever expect this?
No, I did not. I did not. You know, this is my first acting gig, so really I didn't know what to expect.
Taronda Jones plays Portia, Cookie's assistant on the show. Jones, an aspiring rapper.
I'm notorious. R.I.P. to B.I.G. Got tools over 21, like a state ID.
Was working at a nursing home in Chicago when she got the call she was cast.
Terrence, Taraji, everybody else, they're also welcoming. Didn't know me from a can of paint.
Now she's sharing the screen with an Oscar-nominated actress.
I'm gonna call you back. Because she always tells you, just do you, be you, don't worry, have fun. Lights, camera,
action. Which brings us to Taraji P. Henson. She's reunited with her frequent co-star on film, Terrence Howard.
Let me go in.
No, I'm working, Cookie.
Her character, Cookie Lion, is fierce, fabulous, and tells it like it is.
Because I shut it down.
She's uncompromising. She's loyal, even though she made a mistake. She says, so what, I did it for my family, you know. God, she's just a stand-up kind of woman who doesn't take a lot of junk. So I never see this day.
Cookie emerges after being locked up for 17 years. Her children are grown, her husband's moved on, but she's a fighter and is demanding her share.
And I want half my company back.
Music plays a huge part of this show. It can almost be thought of as its own character, but the writers artfully weave it into the storyline.
I think the way the music is used in the show, it's a character. It's not like we do the scene and let's break for the music. The music. break. And now back to the scene. You know, it's like its own character. You're watching the scene, and then all of a sudden, there's a song, and it's like, oh, okay, it's a song match. You know, and I think it's different. It's a different way to see music on drama.
As for the rest of this season,
nobody is safe in the Empire, darling. Right.
The characters will be pushed to the limits. All of them.
You can start by recording for Empire on this phone.
The rest of the season is ridiculous.
I keep on using the term, but it's like, it's just stupid. It's just stupid. It's next level.
This year, my two sons, Hakeem and Jamal Lyon, both are releasing new albums.
To have them be like, yeah, let's dish out some drama. Let's, you know, push the boundaries.
Now, can you protect me or not?
I don't know where we're gonna go next. I don't know how they're going to top.
Coming up next week, we talk fashion with the stylist of the show as she tells us where she finds all of those great clothes. And we take you on set of Empire Enterprises. Empire airs every Wednesday night at 9 right here only on WDRB. Oh my gosh, it was such a fun assignment.
Well, you saw what happened on tonight's episode of Empire. Now we have your behind-the-scenes pass.
We got a tour of the soundstage to show you all the work that goes on before the cameras start rolling.
Lights, camera, action. Tonight
you need to stop playing with me.
More than 50 bottles of Syrah.
I want Empire. I want part of this company.
The word is, you are wasting my time.
You really don't get it, do you? This is about the music.
It seems to be the recipe for success when it comes to the new show, Empire.
You know he's going to leave it all to a kingdom.
They just may kill each other.
Mix an all-star cast with hit songs.
I'm looking for a boy that can make a lot of noise.
With high fashion.
You look nice.
And an intricate storyline.
Let's talk business, shall we?
So this is the soundstage of Empire Enterprises. Just watch out for those flying shoes.
I'm gonna call you back.
But the shoes are only scratching the surface.
Roaches on the wall. Drinking sugar water.
Check out the racks and racks of clothes that fill up the wardrobe room.
Lights turned off.
Costume designer Rita McGee is in charge of it all.
This is such a diverse cast. Do you have a favorite character to dress?
All of them. Really, that's the truth. They're all my favorite characters to dress. Because it's clothes, it's different. It's different characters, different feelings, different moods, different shapes, colors, styles.
I want to fast track it, put it out ahead of the album.
With music mogul Lucius Lyon,
I own the song.
It's all about color and class.
I never forgot about you.
He's very distinctive in the colors that he wears. It's not just a black suit or a brown suit, but he does colors.
But the lead fashionista has to be Taraji P. Henson's character, Cookie Lyon.
It tells a lot of her story. You know, she's caught in a time warp in a bit.
What are you wearing?
What I got locked up in.
Well, we gonna change that real quick.
She wears the outfits that I want to wear, and I'm not sure if I have enough guts to wear them, but that is her.
That's what it is. Yeah. I say that too when I watch it and she puts it on. I'm like, oh my gosh, she's rocking it. I want to wear that. I want to do that.
17 years later, you are still beautiful.
I wouldn't know who Cookie was if I didn't know what she liked to wear. That's a huge part of who she is.
She does all kinds of prints here. And she does fur, she does prints, she does stripes, she does patterns.
But back to the shoes. We dug out that famous pair. This is the shoe that Cookie threw in the hallway.
Are they my size?
The clothes and makeup help actress Caitlin Doubleday channel her manipulative, scheming, sexy character, Rhonda.
She's just very sexy. And I'm not. I'm like a dork.
Portia, get my shoe!
But other characters like Cookie's assistant, Portia.
I don't know. That's what they said on the news.
Don't sit in the makeup chair for even a minute.
Next.
Director Lee Daniels liked everything about Taronda Jones's style. Her hair, her clothes, it's all, well, her.
What you wear is you. Your hair is you.
Yeah.
So you're playing you.
Me.
With a different name.
What a different name.
That's what the DJ said.
I was involved with the pilot as well. So I've been on this project here in Chicago since the beginning.
Joe Bryant is the lead set designer who helped build and create the world of Empire.
Let's roll sound.
An army of designers make sure no detail hasn't been thought of.
We had a staff of about 100 to 110 construction people working on the four different stages that we have here.
Lucius's office is filled with pictures of him posing with everyone from Oprah to the Dalai Lama, and the halls of Empire Records with faux rap album covers.
And this is the conference room where Cookie stirs up trouble and delivers some of her best one-liners.
You guys, excuse us for a moment.
Yes, please. Excuse us for a moment, please. Okay. Lucius, don't touch me like that.
It's a nice feeling. The press that we're getting and all the goodwill has been amazing to be part of this.
I just think that people are being thoroughly entertained. I just think that people are finding themselves in these characters. There is something for everybody. There is not a subject that we don't address.
And you can go to WDRB.com to check out our behind-the-scenes slideshow. And be sure to catch Empire at 9 every Wednesday night right here only on WDRB.